Yeah. Done good, girl.
Easy now.
Ain't looking for gold here, is ya? Cause, I called it.
All right, I'll leave you to it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this lucky button. This one. All right. Shake and what's that? Give me some damn breathing room, will you? You want to start something? Yeah, that's right. Show me some damn respect.
your money and nothing else. Don't make me hurt you.
You'll get nothing from me.
Now, come on.
Stop it, will you?
Right now.
All right, damn it. Got nothing except this.
What did I say? Yep. Good girl. That's a good girl. Yep. Good girl. You're good. Yeah! Yeah, you're doing good. Exactly, you think you're talking?
What the hell is the matter with you?
Ow. Easy, whoa.
White buffalo. Only seen one before. Never managed to bring her down.
So, buying or selling? Okay, let's take a look at it. Oh, I'd pay just about any price for this. Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work. Best gloves I ever saw belonged to a trapper up in Roanoke. Albino beaver fur. Softest thing I ever touched.
Thanks for your assistance. Yeah.
You done good, girl.
Yep. Prone. Who let the simpleton out of the asylum?
That's one.
Shut it!
You got a death wish I'm about to make come true.
There, girl. You good, girl? Yeah.
Good girl. Shh, girl. Yep. Thank you. Come on. There you go.
That could liquefy each of your internal organs in turn and leave you just a puddle on the floor.
Professor, I ain't here to rob you. It's me. I helped you at the pond.
You did? Oh, you did. The buffoon. Hello.
Hello.
I'm not disturbing you.
Of course you are disturbing me, buddy. I almost solved biggest problem and you mess it up!
Did?
No, but I did. I can't get the bloody conductor straight. The geometry of life. The grand theory of power. It's the grand theory of theories. There is just one more big problem. Maybe I solve it, but I can't get it right.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't. Help me adjust these things, and I will show you what I mean. Here, take this.
Oh, well, I'm not much of a scientist.
Well, you are an American. Science is far beyond you. But you make a fine buffoon. Go.
wish I ever went to school so I had a clue what was going on. What now?
Well, now, I come to second the creature after God himself to bring life to this earth. Like this!
Am I missing something?
The switches. The bloody switches. Okay. Climb up there and adjust them for me. Go quick, please. You ready?
Sure. Second time lucky, eh?
Second time? More like 7,000th. This is my life's work. It is incredible. Watch. For now, I am so happy. Oh, you just saw creation's second birth.
I just saw a machine waddle a few steps.
I have a son. I am the luckiest man alive. Those morons, they doubted me.
I'll see you later.
Yes. Yes. Goodbye. Oh.
Yep. Get up.
Yeah!
You done good, girl.
Ayúdeme. Me duele.
I got some medicine.
¿Medicina? ¿Ya para qué? No puedo.
Your mind?
How long you been married?
Yeah.
Whoa, whoa. I ain't finished with you. Yep.
Mister.
Hello.
Buddy? There, girl. You know when you have one of those days? Easy there. You all right? Just shut up. You don't know me. There. Hey there, mister. Hey, mister. Hi there.
Bonjour. mister.
Hello.
Hey there. Howdy. Hi there, ma'am. Hi there, mister.
You there, hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Hey, friend.
Morning.
Some real beautiful country around this area. So, Adam!
You got a strange...
Morning.
Morning to you, sir.
Hey, partner. How's it going? You know what? I'm feeling good today. Hey there, partner.
Bonjour, monsieur.
You see this? Lost your wind, country
Got
man?
Got big mouths, don't you? Bet you wouldn't miss some teeth.
Goddamn lunatic!
Stop, or I start
don't
shooting.
Move. Let's get those hands up nice and high.
Apologies.
Oh, mon Dieu.
We know Hello.
What to look for, so watch out.
I tell you, life ain't easy. Morning, mister.
I hear you.
That's your name.
We'll take care of
it. Morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
All right, boys. Eyes peeled for anything suspect.
Hey, mister.
Joseph.
Thank you.
Looks like somebody escaped the sanitarium.
Must be tough, looking like you.
You can't talk to folk that way.
Did your face get swapped for your ass at birth?
Okay, I gotta take you with me.
I'm never.
You're in for one hell of a jailhouse beat.
They'll give anyone a badge these days, won't they?
This uniform won't mean anything to you.
Hey there, mister.
Hello.
Hi there.
How you doing?
Hey, mister. How are you, ma'am?
Howdy.
Good morning.
Just back off. Relax.
Ah.
Bonjour.
Hi there, mister.
You there, hello.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir.
Hey, partner.
Good morning to you.
Hey, ma'am.
Bien le bonjour, monsieur.
Mister?
Morning.
You lose the scissors in your house? Grab a seat, let's get to work.
Thank you.
ma'am.
Good morning.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello there.
Hey, friend.
Oh, you must know you look bizarre in that.
Hi there, mister.
Tell's your name.
Hi there.
Good morning to you.
How are you, ma'am?
Bonjour, monsieur.
Morning.
Je vous salue.
Ah, shut your mouth.
Oh, you better watch that mouth of yours.
Hey there.
Hey.
Oh. Hi there, mister.
Thank you.
partner. Howdy there.
Hey there, mister.
Howdy.
Hey, what's your problem?
Hey, you. That's close enough.
Yeah.
In the south? In a swamp? This is not for me.
Ah, Mr. Morgan. I haven't seen you for a while.
What are you writing in there all day? Diary of a homeless bean counter?
Those are lofty words from one dressed like a clown.
Can't you remember who owes us money?
Leave me alone.
I haven't mastered that bit.
Or are you working out how much to skim today for the Strauss retirement fund?
Just get away from me!
Maybe I do.
Arthur! Come up here!
You know something?
You boys what don't know are you boy. Wearing?
Morning, dear. You ever miss home?
Sure. All the time.
Must be hard, being so far away.
All right,
surrounded
Arthur.
By icebergs. Slowly starving. And then the boat comes down with the plague. And men are dying like it's a race. The parson, he can't keep up with the funerals. We're burying them 2-3 at a time. And there's 50 sharks chasing the boat just to feast on the corpses. This is a picnic.
Tough.
That ain't tough. See, sharks, that's a holiday.
Tough is arriving in a new city. Both your parents newly dead. No one looking after you except some scumbags you meet on the street. Folks starving, people desperate.
Well, how old were you?
9. I was 9 years old, I've been living on my wits. Hell. Chances to see that, that'd be a joy. Yeah, I tell you, sharks are nothing compared to human beings.
Now, maybe you're right. I guess all life is brutal in its own way.
Exactly. Yeah, it's all just a miserable waste of time.
Appalling.
Dreadful. You know, maybe that's the point.
Could really use some good meat for this stew.
Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
Get up here already.
So, Arthur, you get the deciding vote.
About what? We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? Or deal with business the right way?
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? Leave this country? We need that money.
Just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am.
I've heard that before, and usually I've been right. If you say so.
Quit doubting, Arthur. It does no favors. Come on. We need to go see a man about a boat.
Hurry up! Get away on time!
A boat?
We're headed to a settlement called Le Gras. I met a boatman there called Thomas who knows these waters like the back of his hand.
Why do we need a boat?
So we can attack Bronte's mansion from the swamp. Catch him off guard. He knows we survived the trolley station, so he'll be expecting some kind of reprisal.
All right. Okay, makes sense.
See? I do still possess some capacity for rational thought, Arthur.
There, girl.
Okay, follow me.
Here.
Thank you.
For what?
For taking my side back there.
It ain't about sides.
Feels like Hosea's lost his spine.
This move on Bronte, is it for the bank job or revenge for what happened at the trolley station?
Both. Neither. What does it matter? We need to hit that bank. And Bronte has the police and just about everything else in San Denis in his back pocket. He also set us up. And lest we forget, took young Jack.
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made and what it takes to support 20 people. Let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
With all due respect, Dutch, is this Tahiti plan really gonna work out?
You tell me, Arthur. Is it? Have some goddamn faith! I am bending over backwards to make a future for us!
I know, but...
But? When did you become so small-minded? If you'd rather we break up the family, go our separate ways, just tell me.
Of course not.
This isn't a prison camp. I am not forcing anybody to stay. So either we're in this together, working together to get out together, or we're not. There simply isn't a reality in which we do nothing and get everything.
I know. You're right. This feels like we're on borrowed time again. I mean, the O'Driscolls found us.
Yeah. We need to move. And soon. Haven't I made that clear? I feel like I'm going in circles with all of you. Micah, is the only one left with any loyalty.
Now, that ain't fair.
You are talking like John. I swear that woman is poisoning him against me. I've seen it before. What's the problem here?
There ain't a problem.
You think Micah would question going after Bronte? No! He'd say, let's go!
I'm here, ain't I? I've been at your side for 20 years.
I know. I'm sorry, son. It's just the endless debate about everything is wearing me down. The others, I can take. But when you're not behind me, it hurts.
I'm behind.
Blackwater. Valentine. Rhodes. Sean. Kieran. I promise. None of it will be in vain. Anyway, here we are. Let me do the talking. Thomas. It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's going to help us get close to our prey. The other night, we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
Well, if anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
If you're bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
Be lively. Mind you, there's a lot of gators. Uncommon number. Big ones.
Great.
Come now, Arthur. It'll take more than a prehistoric reptile to scare you, Shirley.
I just want to see you meet your match when it comes to an aging predator with a big mouth, Dutch.
Arthur here is something of a comedian, Thomas. More of a jester than a gunslinger.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Dutch. This way. Come on, this way. Follow me here. And stay on the higher ground.
You call this ground? It feels like water to me.
Down here, we can't be too picky there, Mr. Arthur. Got a couple of crayfish traps up ahead. Mr. Dutch, you keep a lookout for company. Mr. Arthur, check the traps with me.
This one's empty.
All right. I got a few more set over this way. Come on.
I don't want to know what just touched my leg.
Mr. Dutch, you sure you the right fellas to be going after Angelo Bronte?
Oh, he's much more the kind of reptile I can handle.
Now stay close. Make sure you follow my line.
Oh, I fully intend to, Thomas.
You too, Mr. Arthur.
You can see why evening swamp wading hasn't caught on as a pastime, can't you?
I love it out here. Peaceful. Nobody bothering you none. Except for the night folk sometimes.
The night folk?
Yep, some strange people around these parts. Wilder than the animals they are.
Well, this just gets better and better.
Whoa. Stop where you are. It's a gator. Just stay as still as you can.
All right, let's keep moving. I got another trap by that small island up here. I don't know what's taking Jules so long with that boat.
I think we are all equally keen to find him.
There's a trap stuck in the mud. It happens.
Ooh. Guess something didn't want to be caught.
My gosh. So it's true.
What is?
There's been talk of a big old bull, but people talk a lot of nonsense. I guess this was... No, but only something huge could do this.
Oh. Fantastic. Let's hope it bites you first, Dutch.
Should we just keep moving? I don't really want to hang around here much longer.
All right. I suppose this can wait. Let's go. Hold up.
My God, there's no shortage of them.
Good eating.
Us or them?
Exactly. Come on.
We really should have run into Jules by now. I reckon we should split up so we can search both sides.
Okay, Martha, since you appear so at home here, you take the right. We'll go left.
What? Just keep your eyes open.
Someone there? Hello? Jules?
Over here!
That must be him.
Tree. What are you doing?
Yeah.
there's a monster. A monster.
You okay up there?
There's a monster.
Where?
Master, it nearly ate me.
And where'd he go?
It's out there.
What?
A big gator. Big as I ever saw. Big and nasty. Knocked me off the boat and chased me over here.
You must be Jules.
Yes.
Where is the boat?
Over there. I ran.
Okay. Yeah. And where'd this monster swim off to?
I
got the scare. It's over here. Stuck. I don't know. I got it loose. Jump.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go.
Thank God. So, who are these fellas, Thomas?
Two new friends of mine. I'll explain later.
Jules, we are very happy to have finally made your acquaintance.
I thought I was gonna be out here all night.
What you doing hiding up in the tree, boy?
This gator was huge, Thomas. Twice as big as I ever seen. Twice as angry, too.
Now what?
I think we hit a tree stump.
Yeah, I thought we cleared. You're gonna need to jump in and pull us free.
Me?
Yeah, just do it. Won't take you a minute, boy. Go on.
This is a bad idea. You'll see any giant monster long before it gets anywhere near you. You got a couple of crack gunslingers here with the guns loaded. You'll be fine.
You didn't see the thing.
Yeah, neither did you. It's just a myth, Jules. Now pull.
Come on, put your back into it.
Jules?
Shit. He won't kill.
No, I'm going in.
No, no, we can't lose the boat. Arthur will go.
I will?
Quick. Hurry, Arthur.
Come on! Come on!
think he's going? Shit, that is one big old gate. Oh, your boy doesn't look too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop the bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son. You're gonna be okay. Just thank your old Uncle Dutch.
I heard that. There's still a lot of blood. You need to put pressure on it.
I've stopped the bleeding. I think he'll be okay if he don't get a fever.
We can bring down a fever.
A fever is the least of our worries. Look who's back.
God damn it.
Put every...
Be okay, kid.
Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and bad. That's unusual. Normally, the little one's angry. Big one's is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kind of reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squealing.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner.
Can we get some help? Jules has been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you. I'm at your service anytime you need.
Thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm going to head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Brunty. Bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm. I'll see you soon.
You be safe. We got monsters out here.
Well. Easy there. Good girl. You good girl?
So,
you ain't
Dutch,
acting right? No.
What's Tahiti like, anyhow?
Hello, ma'am.
Good Lord, have you looked in the mirror lately?
I'm sorry.
Arthur, there you are. Come on. Thomas, let's get going.
Right you are.
Hey, Bill, you were a sharpshooter in the cavalry, weren't you?
What?
When we get there, maybe you could help with the suppression fire.
I never said I was no sharpshooter.
Oh, that's right. What was it? The nation's most loyal latrine digger, wasn't that it?
Yeah, well, I fought, and I fought well.
So you always tell us.
You taught me something you could do with learning. Them Indians were savages.
Clutch them out there, boy. Watch it. Only type of savage in these parts are moonshine, swilling, pompous, inbred locals.
Dutch, I saw things out there.
I don't doubt you saw things, Bill, but your tiny little mind was too small to comprehend what you saw. What you saw was people who lost everything to savagery. Savagery of peasants. Failures come from Europe to reap some awful vengeance on God's last creation.
Interesting way you boys gotta prepare for a killing.
I'm sorry I wasted my life trying to teach you boys.
Love you though, I do.
Well, leaving love aside, you think we got this?
Don't you never leave love aside, Arthur. It's all we got. Pick us up yonder.
I got you.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Come on, quick. Stay quiet. Lenny, Bill, you're with me. Arthur, John, you take the left side. If you see a shot, you take it. Okay? Good luck, gentlemen. Arthur, let's go.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Shoot that lock, Arthur.
Good. Now kick that damn door. We got more inside.
No, name your price. Name your price. Every man have a price. Eh? Okay, okay. No, I surrender. I surrender.
Should we kill him?
Nah, let's take him to Dutch.
You can carry him. I ain't touching that piece of shit. Are we taking him to Dutch then? Arthur! Like I said, you carry him.
I think Dutch wants to have a little chat, Mr. Bronte.
Today. You ain't police.
in front. Bill, you help.
Got him.
Oh, come on, Lenny.
All right, come on. Let's get out of here.
Yep.
Oh, hey, big man. We gonna ransom you or what?
You're pathetic.
Well, I am. Because from where I'm sitting, you're the one deserving of pity, my friend. All your men, all your money, it weren't no match for a bunch of bumpkins.
You are nothing. You do nothing. You mean nothing. You stand for nothing. Me, I run a city. And when the law catch up to you, you will die like nothing. I am this country. You are what people are running from.
I possess things that you will never understand.
You don't even possess your own men. $1,000 to the man who kills him and sets me free.
What are you gonna say now?
They are even bigger fools than you.
No doubt.
The law will find you. Already, the dogs are on the way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're right. You are so right. They are good at smelling filth, huh? So filth has got to be disposed of. Your friends, the Pinkertons, gonna come and rescue you, you repulsive little maggot. Call them now. You call them.
Jesus.
Part of your philosophy books cover feeding a fella. The goddamn alligator, Dutch.
The part that covers weakness. That part.
I don't know.
Well, I do. It ain't nice. I know it. But it is us or him. I figure it might as well be him.
I'm telling you, Dutch, this is the way to do this job. The distraction will buy you all the time you need.
I wouldn't even ask why you're wearing that.
Always good to see you. We've done the work.
You okay? Don't shame yourself.
Yes, I'm all right. Why?
Okay, just making sure.
Sounds good.
Between you and me, I'm nervous. I suppose that's it.
Jim?
Look, the bank, Karen, Tilly, Abigail, I sent them all. They all say the same thing. There's no more than one armed guard. And the police? It's a city, they're police, but as far as we can tell, the patrols will all be going this way when Abigail and I cause the diversion. That's the opportunity.
What do you think, Arthur?
I don't see we have a lot of choice. We linger around here, we know we're dead.
But the plan...
We got a decent bunch. We know how to fight. The city cops don't seem so tough as long as we move fast. I reckon doing it in the day with a distraction. If that's what Hosea is saying, it's as good a plan as any.
I think I agree.
We do it at night. There's the drama of just getting into the bank. Can't do that silently. They'll pick us off far easier.
I know. I'm just making sure.
Every plan is a good plan if we execute it properly. Every problem we had was because we did not execute properly. Even Blackwater, from my understanding.
You're right. Let's rob this bastard. Everyone get some rest. We ride out in the morning. Look smart. Travel light. You got everything, Arthur?
Sure.
So, we rob ourselves a bank, and within 6 weeks, we're living life anew in a tropical idyll, spending the last of our days as banana farmers. Let's get out of this godforsaken place and go rob ourselves a bank!
Come on, Hosea, get moving! We ain't got all day!
Trying to stay real about all this.
Real? Oh, how I detest that word. So devoid of imagination.
How soon are we shipping out?
Soon as we get a passage organized. Boat down to Argentina, then another around the Cape.
What about the money in Blackwater? We're just gonna leave that behind?
Forget that. It's gone. You all talk like it's the only goddamn money in the world. We're gonna take that and more. Take it from the people who take it from us. This isn't some hick town $100 operation. This is a big city bank.
Right. With security, guards, police.
Hosea has done his reconnaissance. We've been over this. The plan. One last time! Hosea and Abigail, draw out the police. We go in calm and fast. John and Lenny, secure the front doors. Javier takes the side exit. Phil, Micah, and Charles, control the crowd. Me and Arthur, deal with the bank manager and vault.
Gentlemen, let us go ahead.
How long do you need?
Not long. 15 minutes or less. You'll know by the noise. Any problems? We'll see you in camp.
Good luck, gentlemen.
Right on! Yeah! Everybody know the drill. We head in hard. Stay calm. They won't be expecting us. Any minor trouble, head back to camp. We'll leave in a few days. You good, Bill?
Sure. Then right on with Charles. We don't want to be seen heading in like some posse of country outlaws.
This is it, cowboys! One more time!
One more time.
Let's ride! Yeah! Let's hitch up here.
Hey,
Gentlemen, robbing thieves, it ain't no crime. Folk like this, they stole. Country could have been.
Stay cool, fellas. Act natural. Wait for Hosea to do his thing.
This had better work.
Looks like there's law over the other side.
Have a modicum of faith, John, will you please? Soon as we get out, load everything onto the wagon here.
I love that Hosea! He is a true artist. Gentlemen, let's go! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a holdup! Don't do nothing stupid!
Combination for these safes.
Tell him the combination. Come on, speak. Speak or die. Now.
First. Got it.
Okay, now, what's the second number?
72.
All right, should be one more number.
Last number. Come on.
54.
Yep. Okay, I'm in.
What did I tell you?
Well.
Get out of here!
You got trouble! Looks like...
Come on! Let's go!
Shit. Okay.
Clear this out.
Forget all the drawers, just get those safes. I need the combination for these safes.
Tell him the combination. Come on, speak.
Got it.
Okay, now, what's the second number?
72.
All right, should be one more number.
Last number. Come on.
54.
Mr. Rams,
Okay, I'm in.
What did I tell you? Well.
Get out of here!
You got trouble! Looks like the law!
Come on!
Shit!
Let's go!
Okay.
Think we got a problem out here!
Come out! It's over!
Shit! Abigail!
Dutch! Get out here! Get out here now!
Someone must have squealed!
You never should have gone after Bronte, Dutch.
Mr. Milton? Let my friends go! Or folks, they are gonna get shot unnecessarily!
Your friend? Why would I do that?
Come on, Milton!
It's over! No more bargains, no more deals.
Mr. Milton, this is America. You can always cut a deal.
I've given you enough chances.
Hello!
What they got out of here?
control of the bank. The other. They're just trying to hold them off.
Okay.
John.
Killed?
Arrested. I couldn't help.
Well, we better go. We'll be next.
What you think?
I reckon me and Lenny try and find a way across the roof, so if you'll cover us.
Sure, sure. Go on! Follow me, one at a time. Arthur, you go next. Come on, follow me. Keep it down. There's law everywhere. Let's see if we can get to that building.
You people need to move along now.
Ah! We got the law alone. Watch out. Don't believe it.
They knew we were coming. Just like your ferry job in Blackwater.
Ain't nothing like that. What now?
I don't know. I don't. This whole town is filled with cops.
Well, how long are we gonna stay here? A few hours?
We go back to camp? They're gonna get every last one of us. I know they're gonna be watching the roads. I got it. A boat.
What you mean?
We stay here till nightfall. Then we sneak on down to the docks. We get ourselves out of here.
Yeah, where?
Any place will do. That's all I got. We leave. We lie low. We come back for the rest in a few weeks.
I'm guessing it's that. Or we die out there right now.
Exactly. Now, everybody, calm down. I mean, look at us. Okay, follow me, and keep your heads down. Head for the dock. Guards.
can't stay here.
Let's cut through the train. Follow me. Someone's coming. Duck.
I don't see why we have to check the train. They just robbed Lamont. No bank. It's not like they're gonna take the first line out of town.
But old Milton said...
Milton said a lot.
Boats! Come on! Shh. I hear voices.
Tinkertons.
Everyone stay down.
Rats will have to come out of their holes eventually. Should have had them in Blackwater. But that won't happen again. Milton's got men on every street.
We can't stay here.
Let's cut through the train. Follow me. Someone's coming. Look out on the left. Stay low. Someone's coming. Duck.
I don't see why we have to check the train. They just robbed Lemoyne National Bank. It's not like they're gonna take the first line out of town.
But old Milton said...
Milton said a lot. Come on, I won't be out here all night.
Past these fellas. Arthur, head over to the water. See if you can draw them out.
Draw them out? How?
I don't know. Make a noise. Whistle or something.
See them? Sure.
What you think?
I don't know.
They're watching for us.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Well, they ain't just waiting there for no reason.
Yeah. Let me think for a second.
I'll deal with them.
What? How?
I can't kill all of them silently, so when they chase me, you go the other way.
What are you talking about?
You heard what I said.
Oh, I like it.
Real brave.
What in the hell? Who is...
Excuse me, buddy! Hey, stop! Stop, stop!
That is one of the most beautiful acts I ever saw. Come on.
We got some gold.
I'm sure. This boat ain't going to Tahiti by any chance.
I don't know.
John.
Lenny.
Hosea. That wasn't good.
I know. So what are we gonna do now?
Guess I'm gonna introduce myself to the captain. Give him some of this gold to secure his silence.
And find out where we're heading.
How do I look?
Like a shifty, no good killer on the run from the law.
Ain't that the truth?
Excuse me, sir.
Hey, who are you?
Forgive me. A stowaway. Can I see the captain, please? I come in peace. Well, it's gonna take a little more gold, but I think we're gonna be okay. This captain, he is a fine fella. A New Englander from the Cape. The rest of the ship is Frenchmen. They're heading down to the islands, taking some Pennsylvania coal. Now, apparently, we're gonna be able to slip ashore in northern Cuba in a couple of days.
That's so.
Apparently.
What are we gonna do in Cuba, Dutch?
Hold up for a while, then hurry back, gather up the rest of our family. At least we got some money now. Money and loyalty. With that, you can do whatever you please.
So you reckon they'll follow us to Cuba?
Like Colonel Waxman on a jolly? I highly doubt it. I reckon we hold ourselves to ourselves, and this is done and dusted.
Let's hope so.
I ain't no sailor, but, that cloud look like good news to you?
Find another way.
Oh, God damn it!
Dutch. Dutch. Boys.
You're alive. Arthur.
No, boy, that's it.
You're alive.
Arthur.
Arthur. Okay. It is a miracle. It is a goddamn miracle. Have something to drink. Have a drink. Somebody give him a goddamn drink. Oh, son. Son, take it easy. We got you. We got you.
So, where the hell are we?
We are on the island of Guarm.
Javier asked the local.
It's a old sugar plantation island. Second island east of Cuba.
Is it anywhere near Australia or Tahiti?
It's on the way, I guess.
So, what next?
I don't know. Well, next, I guess we're gonna get shot.
Encadenen a estos hombres.
Gentlemen, this is quite a welcome.
Who are you?
Senor, por favor, we are no one.
What's your name?
Aiden O'Malley.
Is that so? What are you doing, Mr. O'Malley?
Surviving. We were lost at sea, in the storm.
Is that so?
No. I'm in the habit of looking like this. Is all of this really necessary?
We got enough troubles around here right now, Mr. O'Malley, without taking a chance on a bunch of vagabonds. Behave yourselves and no harm will befall you.
Vamos!
Vamos! Vamos! Muévanse!
That means move! You got a long walk ahead of you.
I don't get your drift, Mr.
Levi Simon, senior overseer for Alberto Fusar. We run the third most productive sugar plantation in the Northern Caribbean. Of course, where there's money to be made, there's trouble.
What sort of trouble?
Oh, the usual sort. People wanting what ain't theirs and others telling them to take it.
I don't get you.
Labor troubles. And other thieves and pirates looking to disrupt our ways of working.
How very upsetting for you.
Not half as upsetting as it'll be for them. Mr. Fusar has a lot of very powerful friends.
I will bet that he does.
Bunch of Haitian pirates won't frighten him. He's strung up in the streets soon enough.
And do we seem like Haitian pirates to you, Mr. Simon?
You seem like someone or other.
We was headed to Tahiti.
You was going to see the crowd. Just as soon as I know exactly who you are, you'll be free. In the meantime, you'll not starve.
Cabo, llévese a estos hombres a la cárcel, junto con el grupo de cucarachas de ese campesino. Cualquier tontería que hagan, dispárales a todos. Welcome to Guarma, gentlemen. Now, if you'll excuse me. Yeah!
What now, Aiden? I don't know. What do you think?
I think we've got to get out of here.
Yeah, but they can't find out who we are.
Well, for now, we're stuck, Ben.
Well, for what it's worth, I think I would have preferred Tahiti.
You and me both. Who are these people?
Who knows?
Well, they got them chained and lashed, but they don't look too dangerous.
Excuse me, sir. Who are our new friends here?
Criminales.
What crime did they commit?
Insurrection.
Insurrection? That's quite a word.
Cállate, señor Fuentes. Muévanse. Todos.
okay?
Yeah.
Damn. Reinforcements.
Mon Dieu. We need to get out of here.
Now we're in trouble.
Come on, David. Everyone, follow me. Please, David. Come.
Javier!
Get out of here. Get out of here. There's a lot of them.
What do you think?
We gotta move, Dutch.
Cool. Don't lose pace, son. We'll find you.
Cui. Go. Follow me. Quick! What are you doing here?
I have no idea. Running from somebody or something, I guess.
How went we all? Hetul Fontaine.
Dutch Vanderlyn. These drowned rats are Micah, Bill, and Arthur.
Okay. Well, Fusa will be desperate to find you. We must be very careful.
So, who is this Fusor?
A tyrant, driven by nothing but power and greed. Our only purpose is to work ourselves to death to make him rich.
Leon wants the people to stand up to Fusa, but most are too afraid.
And you?
I am not from here. I bring things in and off the islands behind Colonel Fusa's back. Let's rest a moment. Down there is Aqua Dolce, Fusa's compound. The sugarcane these poor men kill themselves farming gets processed in that factory there.
They're little more than slaves shipped in from other islands. A group escaped yesterday into the jungle, hoping to find a way back to their homes.
Now Fusa's men are out hunting them down. That old fort? Cinco Torres. My men and I use that as a hideout when we are here. Come on. I know somewhere you men can rest.
Can we trust you?
I don't see you have any choice. I am the only one who can arrange a boat for you. But I need something in return. Help Leon with that group of escape workers and then come meet me at the fort.
If you help us get back our friend and get out of here, we will do everything we can.
Thank you.
Gracias.
If your friend is still alive, they will have him at Fusa's compound. There is a cave hidden below the cliffs. It will lead you right there.
Thank you.
The workers are somewhere in the jungle. Hopefully we can get to them before Fusa does.
Of course.
Gentlemen.
Well?
Goodbye.
If this is a tropical paradise, so far it ain't up to much.
I'll go scope the entrance to that cave. Arthur?
I need to get some rest.
Well, you're right. We all need to relax. What a mess. I
I'm so sorry, boys.
Get some sleep, Dutch.
Micah, guard this spot. Bill, do some more scouting carefully.